What is going on, WWE SuperCard players around the world, and welcome back to the brand new episode of WWE SuperCard Season 3. And we have the announcement of Season 4 officially here, so this is kind of a different video, which I haven't like done ever in my channel. So this will be actually a top 5 list of the things that I wish, personal list, it's not like everyone's opinion, it's just my wish list of what should be added in Season 4. It's just a top 5 list. If you don't like it, I'm sorry, but I've done my best to bring back all the faults that has happened in Season 3 and to, you know, to better the game in Season 4. So before we start this video, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel if you're new. We're really close to the 1000 mark and I really appreciate each and every one of you. So without further ado, let's get down straight to the top 5 list. Let's go and see what should be added in Season 4. Let's go. Okay, so number 5. My first thing that should be brought back to Season 4 is the old set as champ option which we got in Season 2. Now, if you have played the game in Season 2, you probably know what I'm talking about, where you could set a card, like a specific card, like, let's just see on the screen, I'll show you some Season 2 footage where I could like set any card with any image as a champ with any background of the image. So that's pretty cool. That was like one of the best features I think we had in Season 2, because you could use literally any background. Like for example, like a SummerSlam 17 Bobby Roode can actually be used as a champ with the SummerSlam 17 normal card, or you know, any other Bobby Roode card in across like all the tiers, which was like really really awesome in Season 2. But ever since Season 3 came by, we lost that feature, which was like pretty disappointing. And especially, I'm not a huge fan of the set as champ through catalog, and that's the main reason why Eddie Guerrero is my like champ forever right now, because I really don't think there's a better looking card in the game than that Eddie Guerrero. So I think that'll remain my champ until we get the old set as champ option, which was like really really awesome. So Cat Daddy, if you're watching this, please make sure to bring that feature back. Number 4, pro animations across all game modes. What this means is, ever since Season 3 came by, we lost, I don't think it's a, like a glitch on their part, like they removed the part where the pro animations work across all game modes. Like suppose there was a WrestleMania 33 event pro of like Shawn Michaels or John Cena, whichever card. Once you pro that card, that pro animation does not work in when you set it as champs, and it doesn't work when you like use it in across all game modes. Like even if in wild mode it works till a point, then it doesn't work, which is like pretty annoying. It looked pretty great, so I really hope they bring back that feature too. It still works for the Money in the Bank card, so I think they can probably bring that out in the Season 4, so that like, since we have the Beast tier, Titan tier, and also the Monster tier, so what I hope is that we can also set the champ with the pro animation, as well as we can see that amazing pro animations across all game modes. I think we all would like that, because that would like really make the game visually appealing, and like it would look like pretty awesome. So that's number 4. Now number 3. Better themed events. Now we all know, whenever it comes to doing something new, Cat Daddy is not very good at that. Now I'm not saying that they don't do anything good at all across all seasons, but whenever they try to bring out something new, it looks promising, but once that actual event theme like it starts, it just crashes down and it's like really stupid. So like for example, we just had a pumpkin event which was zombie themed, like we had to collect pumpkins and they'd be revealed as a pro later on, but pro or singles of cards, zombie cards later on. So what I'm saying is, those were pretty much pack baits all the way. Like you cannot pull them across the board, and I'm literally not kidding. I won 4 King of the Rings, I've got 4 pity pulls, and I've also like got a bunch of team battleground rewards, and I actually didn't pull one pumpkin, which was pretty freaking annoying. Like it was like, if I don't spend credit, there's no chance in hell I can get a pumpkin, which was like just pretty annoying. And the same thing happened back in the Ultimate tier when we had the limited edition Undertaker QR code event. Now what went bad there was like, those were like really rare cards, and second of all, they just didn't work out the drop rates of the card, like the actual Undertaker card. Like you had to play while Rumble mode, like everybody played, but I could barely see like one in like, I don't know, maybe 200 or 300 people actually pull the card off the board, which are pretty ridiculous. Like if they do better themed events, that will really help the game a lot. So that was number 3, now let's go to number 2. Not pay to progress. Now don't hate me for this, like, if you played season 1, you probably know what I'm talking about. We had a game mode which is extinct now, which is called PCC. Now what that event was, you need to like play out and make a certain amount of points, and you need to get those points in order to obtain the actual event card. Now those made those event cards like really really prestigious and valuable at that point. Like only 200 people actually were able to get the pro from the event, which was like pretty rare to be honest. Now we all get the stupid ring domination and road to glory, which is way too easy. Everyone can play through that. Everyone has the Kurt Angle Pro, everyone has the Bobby Roode Pro. So what this has made, the game has been like really easy right now. There is like pretty much, if you pay, if you get open packs, if you get the better cards, you can like straight off get every single event card in the game from there on. So that makes the game like really easy to progress if you pay. Now what the concept I'm talking about, if you like really work for your cards, I think that would make the game a lot more better, and the cards would actually be way more valuable. Like if you imagine those season 1 pros, that season 1 PCC pro page, which I couldn't get because I believe I made 16 or 17,000 points in that event myself, and I finished like somewhere around rank 400, which was just not enough to get the pro. Now those events made that card like ridiculously valuable, but now every pro, every card, that you can easily pack them. You can progress, you can play these events. Ring domination is really easy, and Road to Glory is pretty much easy if you have a good deck. So what I'm saying is, just not make it completely pay to progress, just make people earn cards so those cards actually remain valuable for a while. Don't hate me for this, but this is just my opinion. So now the most important thing, number one, which is third event in rotation of the Ring Domination and Road to Glory. Now you don't need me to tell anything more about this, because this has been an issue for like exactly one freaking season, which has been very very long. We didn't get the return of the PCC game mode, which they said they will bring back soon, and whenever they say that word soon, it's never actually soon. So I hope, I really pray they should bring out a new game mode or PCC back to the game like immediately season 4 starts. Because if there's Ring Domination and Road to Glory constantly over and over and over again, I'm pretty sure many people will actually quit this game, because everyone gets to a point when they don't want to play constantly for the same events again and again and again. It just gets too much, you know, repetitive. So I hope we get a third new event in rotation, or they bring back PCC in rotation, so they can add probably 4 events. That would be pretty much like pretty great. And we're getting the Elimination Chamber mode as well, which is pretty cool, I think. But I don't think that's like a proper event. It'll also be like a team battleground, or it'll be like an event which continuously works on. But we probably need a new event or PCC back in the game desperately right now, if they want to keep their old players pretty much like play this game right now. So yeah, that was my list. I hope you all enjoyed it. This was something new I didn't think I will do. My throat is pretty messed up, so I'm probably sounding a bit weird. But yeah, that was my video for today, guys. A top 5 wish list, which I think would personally make the game a lot more better. And like, it would really make fun to play SuperCard again, which most of the people are losing interest by now, because there's already built a huge wall of the number of tiers in the game right now. Like, if I'm a new player, if I see like 15 to 20 tiers to progress to reach the top, I'll just probably quit in a week or two, because like working from rare to like Titan tier in season 4, it'll not be easy. Yeah, you can say they'll give login bonus and stuff, but still, it's a long way, and to keep a player motivated to play without buying packs and like without like doing something like hugely impossible, like it's impossible to get 20 tiers pass through like within a week or two. You'll have to play for a month straight at least. So that was my point. So I hope you'll enjoy this upload. I'll see you guys in the next video. Hopefully we hit 1k by then. I'll see you soon. Take care. Peace out.